What do these things have in common? A flag, a bird, a mammal, a flower, a house, and a statue. At first glance, nothing may come to mind. The list seems about as random as the color of the gumball you'll get from a gumball machine. What if I told you that the flag has 13 red and white stripes and 50 white stars on a patch of blue? The bird is a bald eagle. The mammal is a North American bison. The flower is a rose. The house is the White House. And the statue is the Statue of Liberty. The list may not seem so random anymore. All these things are some of the national symbols for the United States of America. So what do these national symbols mean, and why do we have them? Each of these symbols has a reason for being a national symbol today. The American flag. What does the American flag mean to you? The flag has gone through many physical appearances. The flag we use today has 13 alternating red and white stripes that represent the 13 original colonies. It also has 50 white stars that represent the 50 states. The flag consists of the colors red, white, and blue. Red is for bravery, white is for innocence, and blue is for justice. Overall, the flag represents freedom for the people in America. What other things could our flag stand for? The bald eagle. The bald eagle was chosen to be our national bird on June 20th, 1782. It was believed that this bird was unique to North America, although that was later proven to be false. During World War I, the eagle was a good representation of the preparedness of the United States. Eagles live long lives, they have a majestic appearance, and they have great strength. All qualities that make up America. The eagle, just like the flag, represents freedom in our country. The North American bison. This mammal became our national mammal on May 9th, 2016. Why do you think our national mammal was just recently chosen? President Barack Obama signed the National Bison Legacy Act, making the bison another one of our national symbols. Bison have been getting close to extinction in the past several years. Many people hope that with the new act that the president signed, we will be able to protect bison and see them roaming around North America a while longer. This act also signifies our first successful approach into wildlife conservation. The rose. The rose became a national symbol on November 20th, 1986. Members of the Senate passed a resolution asking President Ronald Reagan to make the rose our national flower. When he signed the proclamation, a ceremony was held in the White House Rose Garden. The Rose Garden was built by our first president, George Washington, where he grew flowers for his mother. It has been remodeled since then, but roses are always there. Roses grow naturally in each of the 50 states, and they have been around for 35 million years. The rose represents life, love, and devotion. The White House. The White House resides in Washington, D.C., a place where our first president, George Washington, decided to group our leaders together. George Washington signed an act of Congress in 1790 stating that federal government officials would live in a district that was not 10 miles away from the Potomac River. Since that time, all of our presidents to this day have lived in the White House. Why do you think it was important to George Washington to have leaders live near each other? It was built in the 1790s, but President Theodore Roosevelt is the one who coined the name White House. The White House stands for freedom and democracy. It is a reminder of our nation's history, and it represents the president and the American people. The Statue of Liberty. The Statue of Liberty is a national symbol, also known as Lady Liberty. It was given to America as a gift from France, which President Grover Cleveland accepted on October 28, 1886. Its original meaning was the friendship between France and America, and the liberty both countries wanted. Over the years, that meaning has changed into something more personal. The torch symbolizes enlightenment. Its fire lights the way to freedom and liberty. The statue itself represents hope and opportunities for immigrants and natives alike. Hope that things will turn out okay, and opportunities that will lead to better lives. Our country holds a lot of history to it, and all of it can be represented by these symbols. Now that we know the meanings of six of America's national symbols, let's find out why we even have them. National symbols help create a national identity. One big reason as to why we have national symbols can be put into one word: pride. We like to know where we are from, and we like others to know that as well. We take pride in knowing that we live in the land of the free. As Americans, we also embrace patriotism. The flag is the most common national symbol you'll see around the United States. We celebrate its colors, red, white, and blue, on not only one, but four holidays: Flag Day, Memorial Day, Veterans Day, and Independence Day. On these four holidays, you are sure to see the American flag waving around. So what do these national symbols mean, and why do we have them? Let's review. The six national symbols we studied today were the American flag, the bald eagle, the North American bison, the rose, the White House, and the Statue of Liberty. The flag represents our country's 13 original colonies and 50 states, which all unified to become the United States of America. The bald eagle represents freedom and strength of our country. The bison represents our ability to recognize wildlife as important and necessary for our future. The rose represents love and life that flourish in our country. The White House represents democracy, our government, and the people in America. The Statue of Liberty represents the hopes, dreams, and opportunities of the people living here. All of these six national symbols help create our national identity, give us a sense of pride, and allow us to be patriotic. What other national symbols do you know about?